What an exciting morning on the Voice of Resurrection devotional. The Lord woke you up today on a mission, on an assignment to touch someone for Him. We want to begin a new study this week, co-laborers with God. Co-laborers with God. Beloved, God's will, as we'll find out this week, is for you and I to bear fruit, and that a fruit should remain. I have said that one of the greatest blessings you will experience in this life, to be God's answer to someone else's prayers. When you are His answer, when you are in the right place at the right time. God blesses us tremendously because we are His agents. We are His ambassadors. We are His representatives. Let's look at our text from 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 9. For we are laborers together with God. Ye are God's husbandry. Ye are God's building. That's our text, beloved. For we are laborers together with God. In other words, we are His partners. It was an amazing thing when the Holy Spirit opened my eyes to understand that I don't work for God, that I work with God. You don't do for Him. That's religion. He does with you. Spiritual maturity, growth, understanding is that my assignment is to effect the will of God on the earth. Jesus taught us to pray, "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven." So, ministry is not activity. Ministry is a targeted response. God shows us, and then we act it out. He reveals to us, and we effect it. Co-laborers. There is no way a man can walk with God and labor with God, and they're self-willed and independent. That is not possible. Beloved, it is the surrender of my own agenda, my own desires, my own ambition that allows me to enter into God's plan for my day. I mean, I want you to understand that you don't have to be in full-time ministry. This is the job of every believer, to labor with God. That when you begin, maybe you're a mother and you're taking care of young children, yes, God has an agenda for you. God wants to work with you to effect change, to manifest blessings, to reveal Himself and His mighty works through us. As I've shared with pastors, instead of having your personal goals and ambitions, you're trying to do great things for yourself. Beloved, what you need to do is ask God to show you His works on the earth, and show you your path in it, or your part in it. That's the only thing that matters. As we study along this line, you will discover that that is the only thing that makes sense. First of all, you don't even want to be anything heaven doesn't recognize. Those of you that have been ordained bishops, apostles, and all these special offices, does heaven recognize your title? Was there an unction from the Lord that you are called to it? If Jesus showed up today, will he address you as an apostle? Will he address you as a bishop? Will he address you as a pastor? Will he address you as a teacher? As an evangelist? You have the title, but does heaven recognize it? Beloved, we are called to labor with God. God cannot partner with a fake. God cannot partner with an office he did not appoint. He did not choose. Do you want to inherit great fruit in eternal life? Then invite God into your day. Then work with God. Listen to God. May he make you an instrument of grace. An instrument, a new, sharp, threshing instrument, having teeth, so that you will be able to impact people, touch their lives, even as God has ordained. May you go forth today and have a blast laboring with God, touching lives for the kingdom. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.